Wagwan beautiful people, I am Chef B. If you're new to this channel, welcome Wagwan. Make sure you're subscribed down below. Now, today's video is going to be a wig styling. And the hair that I'm using today is from Tinashe Hair. And this is a loose, deep wave wig. And straight out of the package, the knots were dark, so I had to bleach the knots a bit, and also I did a light plucking. I do a couple of videos on how I bleach my knots and pluck the lace, so I'll leave a link to a video that you can see. So I didn't want to like bombard this video with like the basics. So so after I did a light bleaching and I plucked the lace so that it looks a little bit more natural, I'm going to be doing my typical method of how I install my wig, which is using the Got to Be freezing spray on the lace. And that is before I cut the extra lace off of the wig. Now obviously you don't want to put the wig on your edges. I brought it forward onto my forehead, and then after I have sprayed the Got to Be freezing spray, then use the blow dryer for a couple of seconds to make sure that it's dry. I'm going to cut the corners, as you guys saw, of the lace, and then lift it a little bit, and then I'm going to remove the excess lace. Now your wig is going to lift a little bit in the very front because obviously you had to lift it to see where you're cutting, or for some people they cut the extra lace before they tacked on the wig, but I prefer this method. I get better results when I do this, and that's just me. So after I've removed the excess lace, I'm going to use some more of the Got to Be freezing spray to re-tack down, is that even a word, to melt my lace. And then I'm going to use this molding wrap that you can get at your beauty supply store or on Amazon to make the lace melt. Now for this wig, as you guys can see, it is a loose deep, like I stated, and I did wash the wig, so it is a little bit on the not so, what do you call it, I don't even know what to refer to, this as, like I'm all tongue twisted right now. So anyways, I want to make sure that the curls are a little bit more uniformed, so I'm going to use a wand iron that I got from Amazon to just do some wand curls. So I did them a little bit on the tight side because I wanted it to look a little bit more uniformed. I didn't want it to look like super loose, like how the wig is already looking. I just wanted my curls to be a little bit more tight. It's like we're going for that late 80s type of, I don't even know which decade I'm talking about, but I just wanted it to have this like old time red lip, black hair, big curly type of look. So that was what I was going for, and I knew that I had to get the curls really tight to get that big hair look. So initially when I did the wand curl, you could leave the hair as is with these type of curls, but I'm gonna show you guys later on how I brush it out to make the hair bigger. So this did take some time, honestly. You don't have to do all of this, but being how extra I am and how I wanted the curls to look, I took the time to do the entire hair, that small of a section throughout. Like, yeah, I got real tired, I got lazy, I'm like, you know what, I'm gonna just throw some curls in this. I didn't even let it stay on the wand for too long. I'm like, okay, I'm just over it at that point. So yes, I'm just gonna finish that up, show you guys how I complete the curls, and then I'm going to do my makeup and then style the hair how I want it. Thank you. Now that I've completed the curls, I just did a little bit of a edge situation, like some soup to the doop type style. So not full out baby hairs, but just a little bit of leave out there in the front. Well, not leave out, but like a little bit of some edge situation to help hide the lace a little bit more. And after sitting on my butt doing all them curls, I'm gonna go ahead and brush it out. So you can use a wide bristle brush or any type of big wide brush that you have, and I brush it from the ends first and then work my way up to the top. And so yeah, I'm just going for that big Hollywood type vibe with the red lips and ish. Like I was just going for this bougie auntie look. Like honestly, y'all know I love the whole auntie wig look. I'm giving y'all rich auntie vibes with this wig, okay? That is what we are aiming for. So I'm just gonna take the brush and just brush it out, but at the same time clumping the curls together. Now I'm gonna use some argan oil, and this is a light type of oil, so it compared to like other oils that you shouldn't use in the wigs because they tend to make the wig heavy and weighed down, argan oil is like really light. So I use that on the ends especially because they get a little bit frizzy with the whole flat ironing and then brushing it out. And I use it at the very top where the parting is so that it looks, you know, shiny, but not like overly shiny and heavy, but like give the hair that glow. So you can also use spray sheen, oil sheen if you have that. And then I use the mousse at the very top to help with the flyaways so I don't have flyaways. So as I said, I'm going to use the oil on the ends to help with make sure the ends doesn't look trashy, but at the same time I want it to be big and fluffy. So that is basically what we're going for. So I'm going to use a brush once more, and then I'm just taking like a handful of hair, brushing it together so that they clump together to give that big wavy look. And sis, I am so feeling this. This hair got me feeling bougie as hell, okay? Like I'm super feeling this wig. So the details for this hair will be down in my description box below, which will take you directly to the hair, so you'll have all that information. So don't forget to follow me on Instagram, Snapchat, and Twitter at damnthatschef. If you haven't subscribed to the channel as yet, go on ahead and make sure that you're subscribed down below. I love you guys so much for watching. Go on, big up on yourself. Bye guys.